Hi, everyone. I'm Wendy Herrick, the head of digital supply chain at Unilever. And at Unilever, our focus is to meet the customer and consumer demands by delivering sustainable, innovative products that meet their needs every day. As consumers, we've become accustomed to getting what we want, when we want it, and seeing products delivered to our doorstep just with a click of a button. But we don't see the hundreds of signals and things that go on behind the scenes that are sent and decisions are made to fulfill those orders. At Unilever, we're transforming our supply chain to be able to anticipate and seamlessly react and respond to customer and consumer demands. To do that, we're building an end-to-end, self-driving, cognitive supply chain. And as you can imagine, this is something we can't do on our own. So partnerships with technology companies are crucial to achieving that ambition. Today, I have the distinct pleasure of speaking with Frederic Laloyo, founder and CEO of Aera, with whom we are building a cognitive intelligence at scale. So hi, Fred, and thanks so much for joining me today.
Thanks, Wendy. Great to be here.
So let's start our session today, Fred, by giving an introduction to Aera. Who is Aera? What do you do? What does the team do?
Aera is a Silicon Valley-based software company with a very clear vision to build the technology platform that would enable what we called at the time the self-driving enterprise, anchored on the realization that there was a need for decision automation, decision augmentation for some of the world's largest organizations.
What does cognitive automation really mean, Fred?
Yeah, it's a digital brain that understands how your business works, that makes real-time recommendations, that predicts business outcome, but is also able to act autonomously. And that's a very important element. And we've deployed that with Unilever, is the ability to take action. So the brain is autonomous in its thinking and its inability to act, but it works hand in hand with the operators. The brain is guided by the operators on a day-to-day basis. So it amplifies your decision-making abilities, and it also augments the quality, it improves the quality of the decisions. As the system is running, it builds a memory of all the decisions that are made, and it can learn from that. So as the system is running, you build a permanent memory of the decisions made, and you can start leveraging that memory to increase and improve the quality of the decisions that you make.
Based on all that, how novel is this technology? How forward-thinking is it, Fred?
I think it's quite innovative. It's quite novel. But let me explain how. We're really moving from an era of people doing the work, making decisions, planning, optimizing, leveraging data, tools, collaboration platforms, and so on and so forth, to an era with Aera, of the digital brain, the machines doing the work, guided by people. So I think it's a fundamental shift in the way work is being done inside an organization. I believe that we're coming to the end of this era of we're going to ask people to do more. For the last 20, 30 years, right, all the decisions are made by people and we can't cope. We are humans. We have to take a break once in a while. And the machines can actually deliver what the humans cannot. So, you know, the symbiosis between the two is this interesting part. And I believe that we're really at the forefront here of a massive wave of transformation.
One of the things for me anyway, that made Aera very special in this AI ML world, and what really sold and where Aera is now our chosen system of intelligence is you have a transparent box where you actually see what's going on and help people understand that brain, how it's ticking, how it's learning.
So we built the technology from the get-go with transparency in mind. Now, the challenge of a digital brain is it does multiple things. So how do I have a universal language that allows the users to trust the brain? We're deploying that trust by allowing the users to test and build the confidence with the system, by accepting the recommendations from the tool, rejecting them, and learning with the tool. And as we go, the system says, hey, you know what, Wendy? I've been asking you that question 5 times in that context, and you've always given me the same answer. Are you okay if the 6th time, actually, I do it on my own? And you can say, yes, I'm okay with that. So that level of automation, that level of trust has to be bottom up, and has to be based on a language that is spoken in with words and numbers and not just gibberish, and a vertical lineage of the decision so that you understand at any point in time, what is the logic of the brain, right? Is ERA telling you that trust is being built today?
Absolutely. And it's really been a critical element, again, you know, putting the users at the front, right? Just implementing a tool. So that's been a huge a journey together, which I think's driven success.
So how is cognitive automation helping and has helped Unilever during the COVID crisis?
Absolutely. Well, you guys really helped us in simulation at this time, right? Because the data that we had based on history, all the different signals, it was crazy, right? You couldn't predict anything. So that simulation and all those different models that we worked on together was so important. And in fact, it really helped us pinpoint pretty fast where we were going to have supply issues, right? And not just at the factories, more with our suppliers as well. When were we going to have risks with some raw and packaging materials? How could we get ahead of that to make sure that we could bring product to the consumer? And especially if you look at some of our products in soap and hygiene and all the different things that we have, you know, the consumer really needed to make sure that we continue to do that. So the simulation work that we did with you was highly, highly effective. So just changing it up a little, Fred, what has the partnership with Unilever meant to you and the ERA team?
For me to be able to work with my team and say, look, Unilever is embracing our vision. Wow. That was a big moment, right? Just that validation was huge because we threw ourselves into that journey. And I promise you that when we talked about self-driving enterprise 5 years ago, people were looking at us going like, they're cuckoo, right? So that validation became, and then we started working together and being able to experiment and work together. And that, to me, was an incredible morale booster and giving us the confidence to continue. You actually deployed the spirit of innovation is something that seems to be anchored at the very top of the company. And you're exposing your partners to that. There's no fear. You're really open about exposing the startups to the inner workings of the company. We've been working together for a few years now, so time for me to ask you a question. What are the main benefits that you're seeing from the partnership with ERA? I'm curious to hear.
It's the shared values and objectives, right? And you might not consider that, it's more of a soft benefit, but that really, really inspires innovation and the way we work together to deliver things faster and smarter. But I would also say, you know, growth in service and servicing our consumer and customer in a sustainable way is at the core of Unilever, right? And then it's part of our business strategy, our compass. And so growth in service, but also, you know, climate and sustainability, you know, we've seen efficiencies in energy, water, waste reduction, and of course, costs and cash, right? Inventories and costs, but smarter, faster decisions. And that speed and agility has been absolutely critical. You know, it's allowed us to really anticipate what's going to happen before it happens, you know, predicting it so we can prescribe and automate what we need to do to meet those business needs. So, you know, you spoke about data earlier, and technology is so important and it's scalable, right? The human just can't do all that it needs to do, and especially in times of crisis, in times of COVID, right? And ERA has so many skills that we can employ so that we can help our employees make smarter, faster decisions. Again, all about helping us win in the marketplace with our consumers and our customers. So Fred, thank you so much for taking the time today, and to you and your team for such a wonderful partnership.
Thank you, Wendy. Thank you.